Welcome to the tutorials. I'm happy to see you here. Let's start with the basics. First, we should start with the camera controls. Great. Let's move on to the next. As you see, our people are in front of the oxygen center. When they are out, they use oxygen tanks. We have to keep the oxygen. Perfect. Here we can see the total energy consumption of the oxygen center and also our constructors list. Our constructors are always ready and will start working as soon as you plan a construction. Let's move on to the energy menu. Here we can see our energy resources. There is only coal right now, but we'll hopefully move on to sustainable energy resources later. Now let's focus on coal. To keep the oxygen center running, our people should be sent to the ruins to collect the required coal. Very good. By doing that, we assign the profession of scavenger to those settlers. Let's open the professions menu and see the workplaces. Awesome. Here we can see all assigned professions. If no profession is assigned to a settler, it means the settler becomes a constructor. Now it's time to focus on basic needs: water, food, and houses. Great! Now we have a water purifier where we can produce water. When a certain amount is produced, now let's focus on food production. It's best to start with a fishing dock. Well done! We've now taken care of our basic supply of food and water. You should make sure that enough food and water are on hand at all times. Now let's build a canteen so that our people can visit when they are hungry or thirsty. If there is no canteen in your settlement, they go to good. Now we have a canteen. Our people prefer the closest canteen to them when they are hungry or thirsty. On the other hand, canteen workers prefer the closest store to pick up the required food and water. Now let's focus on constructing some houses.
We have an oxygen center.
Thank you.
Excellent. Now our people have houses to rest, have kids, and more importantly, fill up the oxygen tanks. Let's build some roads for faster walking speed. Perfect. Now our people will walk faster when they are on the roads. You should also know that roads don't require any construction material but can only be built by construction workers. Welcome again. Let's continue with the challenges. Wind is one of the main challenges in this world because winds bring toxic gas. Since the winds bring toxic gases, our people can get sick on these windy days and die if they are not treated. Therefore, we should build a medical post. Great! The medical post is built as planned. Our people can go there if they are sick and stay there until they... Since the oxygen center consumes more energy during the winds, we should store a considerable amount of coal before the winds. Let's build a coal... Very good. Now we have enough coal for the up. Now we should run the oxygen generators in all of the buildings. Workers don't consume more. Perfect. You can also run the oxygen generator in any specific building you need. If it's off, workers consume oxygen tanks. Now let's check the buildings with sufficient oxygen. Awesome. You should also know that there are some buildings where oxygen generators work automatic. Now let's check the energy consumption. Amazing. Now you know how to control your building's oxygen sufficiency and energy consumption. As these oxygen generators increase your energy consumption. Now it's time to take action regarding cracks. Cracks explode if there is no gas extractor placed on them. Then, they start releasing toxic gases and... Very well. Now we have a research center and had a good research. Let's use the research points to unlock the gas extractor. Well done. Now you know how to use your research point. Now we should build a gas extractor on the crack. It is the only... Excellent. Now we've protected our people from a possible explosion. Now it's time to take care of the dead trees and revive them. Trees require a lot of water to reach the required vitality for... Great. When a tree's vitality reaches the required percentage, it generates a tree dome and acts as a natural oxygen center. Any building under a tree dome has no energy consumption. People don't get sick during the winds and also don't consume oxygen tanks under a tree dome. Welcome again. Let's continue with our people's confidence. Our people's confidence is quite important, especially regarding productivity and a vote of confidence. Great. As you see, you can do several things to increase the vote of confidence. Let's start with a nice cafe for our people to... Thank you. Very well. Now our people can enjoy their free time at this cafe. Now let's focus on some decorations and build a spa. Perfect. Now our people can enjoy their free time when they visit this decoration. Each now it's time to build some high-level comfort duplex build. Very good. These buildings also have high-speed oxygen filler. Therefore, now let's build a temple for a thank you. well done. Now we have a temple. Each visit to this temple brings X. Now let's build a playground for our lovely... Excellent. Now you know the main parameters of the vote of confidence. Keep it as high as possible. Otherwise, our people may leave us in the future. Welcome again. Let's continue with exploration. Now it's time to build a submarine dock by the river so that new people can join us by using it. Awesome! Now we can find new people by using the submarine dock. Now let's prepare some canned fish for our expedition team. very well. Now we can produce as many canned fish as we need for the signal tower. Now it's time to build a signal tower. Perfect. Now we have a signal tower. You can now let's build a radar and discover new materials. Thank you. Well done. You've completed the tutorial successfully. Please go back to the main menu and start a real journey.